But first, it's time for Frank Conniff's America.
Welcome to Frank Conniff's America. I'm Frank Conniff, and my guest today is Clarence Lewis, the singer-songwriter known for his biting songs of political satire.
That's right, Frank. It's great to be here on Frank Conniff's America. I hope you're not easily offended, because today I'm going to mercilessly attack some sacred cows, like this first song, a little ditty about Kim Jong-il.
Already? Wow, you don't waste any time taking on the taboo subjects, do you?
I certainly don't. Here's the song. Kim Jong-il has just died. He had one hell of a ride. There's much more about him to be said, but I won't speak disrespectfully of the dead.
That's it? That's the whole song?
It sure is. Hey, if I stepped on any toes, too bad!
But you didn't say anything critical about his regime.
Oh, come on! The man's funeral was only yesterday. One of his family members heard me saying some nasty things about him. That wouldn't be very nice.
Yeah, but as a political satirist...
I will take on any subject. And right now, we're going to be joined by my daughter, Clarice, who I'm proud to say is carrying on the family tradition of incendiary musical satire.
Thanks, Dad. Hi, Frank. Thanks for having me on Frank Conniff's America.
So, you do songs that are just like your father's?
Yes, but I sing protest songs that are from a younger, more feminist perspective, like this one that celebrates the Occupy Wall Street movement.
Wow. Well, it doesn't get any more topical than that.
Yes. Here's my song. Every gal and every guy is joining up with Occupy. Those fat cat bankers are rich as can be. I sure hope one of them will marry me.
That song is supposed to be from a feminist perspective?
Yes. Look, I'm an activist, singer, songwriter, dedicated to societal change. But what gal wouldn't want to snag a dreamy one percenter?
I'm not so sure that that's the case with all... that doesn't sound...
She's a real chip off the old block, isn't she? And right now, both of us are going to team up for a duet that dares to attack the commercialization of Christmas.
Well, I'm certainly all for that.
Great! Strap yourself in, and here's the song. Christmas is now so despised.
Because it's been commercialized.
But for great savings that will warm your heart.
Run, don't walk to the nearest Walmart.
Wait a minute. Did Walmart pay you to sing that song?
Yeah, so what of it?
Aren't you being a total sellout?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. All of those fabulous Walmart products are gonna sell out if folks don't rush over for the great store-wide savings.
You tell him, Daddy. And you listen to me, Mr. Frank Conniff. I'm sorry if our revolutionary call to arms is so upsetting to you. Times like these require courage. And we will speak the truth. And we will not back down.
But you just did a song attacking commercialization that was sponsored by a major corporation.
Daddy, the mean man is upsetting me. Please make the mean man go away. He put a boo-boo on my heart.
Oh, there, there, honey. It's okay. Daddy's here. Frank, you should be ashamed of yourself. I now declare that never again will we appear on Frank Conniff's America.
But you already signed to appear here several more times with an option for you and your daughter to get your own spin-off show.
Oh, that's right. Well, in that case, we'll see you next time. Right, Pumpkin?
Right, Daddy. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Thank you, and thanks for joining me on Frank Conniff's America.
Let's get out of here.
I'm going to play a Let's Get Out of Here song.